You're watching News 8 Now. I'm Meghan Torjussen.
And I'm Katie Thompson. Continuing our coverage of Wednesday night's standoff in a frat house just off the USM campus in Gorham.
The suspect facing criminal charges and could be in trouble with his fraternity as well. Police arrested 23-year-old Alan Santos. After three long hours of negotiations, Santos could potentially receive disciplinary action from his fraternity. That fraternity owns the off-campus house, and its director says guns are allowed if a student legally owns one. But right now, it's still unclear if Santos owns the gun. Santos faces charges of aggravated reckless criminal conduct, criminal threatening with a dangerous weapon, and terrorizing. His first court appearance is scheduled for this afternoon.
The Wyndham Animal Control officer facing child pornography charges is now free on bail. Members of the State Police Computer Crimes Task Force arrested Joseph Payton at his home in Casco yesterday afternoon and seized his computer. Payton previously served as a volunteer member of the Casco Fire Department.
The mother of missing toddler Ayla Reynolds continues to pressure police for answers over her daughter's disappearance. Now, along with a group of supporters, Trista Reynolds will be holding a rally outside the Waterville Police Department tomorrow around noon. Ayla's been missing now for 2 years. Investigators have said they believe the little girl is dead.
And there's a delay for those in Maine who depend on unemployment benefits. About 2,200 Mainers who filed for benefits earlier this week on Monday night, Tuesday, or Wednesday will be getting their checks later than expected. The Maine Department of Labor blames a computer glitch for the delay. Thanks for tuning in to this News 8 Now update. I'm Katie Thompson.
And I'm Meghan Torjussen. Make sure to check back at WMTW.com and our mobile app for the top stories and weather anytime. Have a good day, everybody.